A very good morning, Om Shanti. Welcome back to your 294th day of a Godly blessing. What does Baba want us to learn over here? He wants us to be somebody who is a true server, somebody who serves not just through words, but also through actions, through thoughts. And people can see them and then copy them to bring about a change in their life for peace and happiness in their own lives. So God wants us to become that kind of a soul. So let's see what does Baba have to say here. Baba says, may you be a true server who constantly experiences victory with your own transformation. First, whose transformation? My own transformation. I cannot change the world by transforming others or pushing them to or forcing them to change their ways so that I have peace in my life, I have happiness in my life. No. My happiness, my peace depends upon how I respond, how I react, how I perceive everything which is coming or being thrown at me in terms of situations, in terms of what people think about me. It's all how I perceive and how I react to it. Let's get into the details. So Baba says, just as you have become constant yogis. Yogis are those who are in meditation even while sleeping, even while eating, even while bathing, even while washing the clothes, even while taking care of their household chores, while washing the utensils, while brooming the floor. That is what a yogi is. Yogi is not somebody who's cross-legged, sitting down and closing his eyes and in meditative pose. God says you are a constant yogi. You're doing karma yoga, because when we are sitting, we are not doing major karma. When we are in the daily life and we are doing daily chores, that's the time when we face issues and problems or we have conflicts with others. God says, if you're in yoga with me, then you will choose values and virtues and your karmas will automatically become pure. That's why I become a karma yogi, not a karma sannyasi. So Baba says, just as you have become constant yogis, similarly become constantly victorious and you will become true servers. This is because when a victorious soul experiences victory in every thought and at every step, when you have a thought and that thought is for the benefit of the whole world and it comes true, it matures, that seed matures and turns into a small plant. That is, you're victorious. This is because when a victorious soul experiences victory in every thought and at every step, many souls are automatically served because they are looking at them. Let's see whether he falls or not, whether he's thinking so pure, whether his ideas go ahead or not. Because many people think in this world you have to be crooked to succeed in life. You have to be somebody who pushes everybody else down and moves ahead in life. And in Brahmakumaris, we learn that when we move other people ahead of us, that's where we become leaders. So God says, when other people see that this righteous way can also succeed in this world, which is known as the Iron Age or the Kali Yuga, where there's darkness all around and you are able to succeed through godly ways, then other people are watching and then they'll see, okay, how is that possible? How did he do it? How did she do it? Let me also follow it. Let me also find out, because this is the righteous path and this is the most peaceful path. At least I'll have a good night's sleep when I'm on the righteous path. So they look at us and they follow. So God then says, are automatically served when they see their transformation. Their eyes give the experience of spirituality. So those souls who are on the righteous path, you can look into their eyes and you can find out that they don't have stress. They don't have so much of burden over their heads of their sins, of their karmas, which they've done by choosing vices over virtues. So their eyes are automatically very peaceful and spiritual. They don't have greed, they don't have lust, which is coming out of their eyes. Because eyes are the window to the soul. So then God says, behavior gives a vision of the Father's activities. And their behavior gives a vision of the Father's activities. And the jewel on their forehead, jewel is the soul, the white light. That is the noor, or that is the light, or that is the light of purity. So God says, gives a vision of the jewel of contentment. Special souls who serve with their avyakt image. This is vyakt, means physical. Avyakt means the spiritual image, spiritual power and spiritual light of our thoughts, are called true servers. So people in the world, they serve through the flesh, means by giving things for the flesh, food, clothes. God wants us to serve not of the flesh, but something which will last much more longer, which is the spiritual essence. That means you give a soul light of God. the divine knowledge of God, and that soul can be on the right path from there on, instead of depending upon limited things, food, wealth, comforts for limited happiness. All those will follow when the soul inside is peaceful, for that God wants us to transform so that other people can look at us and transform themselves. So how do you do that? You can learn it at Brahmakumaris Godly Spiritual University, which I'm sure is very close to your own home, or could be next door, or could be in your city. Do visit them for a 7-day free course. Have a blessed day. Om Shanti.